be reading Polaris by H.P. Lovecraft. Without further ado, let's get started. Into the north window of my chamber glows the pole star. When it is cloudy, I can sleep. Well, do I remember the night of the great aurora when over the swamp played the shocking coruscations of the demon light? After the beam came clouds, and then I slept. It was under a horned waning moon that I saw the city for the first time. Still and solemn did it lie. In the marble streets were marble pillars, the upper parts of which were carved into the images of grave bearded men. The air was warm and stirred not. Overhead, scarce 10 degrees from the zenith, watching pole star. Long did I gaze on the city, but the day came not, when red algorithm, which blinked low in the sky but never set, had crawled a quarter of the way around the horizon. I saw light and motion in the houses and the streets, forms strangely bobbed, but at once noble and familiar walked ahead under the horned waning moon. And when the red Alberon had crawled more than halfway around the horizon, there were again darkness and silence. When I awakened, I was not as I had been. Upon my memory was graven the vision of the city, and within my soul had arisen another recollection of whose nature I was not then certain. Thereafter, on the cloudy nights when I could sleep, I saw the city often, sometimes under the hot yellow rays of a sun which did not set, but which wheeled low around the horizon, and on the clear nights, the pole star leered as never before. Gradually, I came to wonder what might be my place in the city on that strange plateau. At first, content to view the scene as an all-observant, uncorporeal presence, I now desire to define my relation to it and to speak my mind amongst the grave men who conversed each day in the public squares. I said to myself, this is no dream. By far, what it means, I can prove the greater reality of that other life in the House of Stone. Spheres, 26,000 years, have revolved. appears to convey some message, yet recalls nothing save that it once had a message to convey. I hope you guys enjoyed that story. I found it really interesting. It sounds to me like his dreams are more nightmares. But I guess, who knows? It perhaps is all in how you perceive it. I think what he writes is very, very beautiful. And so far, I really enjoy H.P. Lovecraft. His description, his prose, I find it very beautiful. I hope you guys also enjoy it. Have an incredible, incredible day and an incredible week. I will see you back here next Sunday for a new story.